Weed, marijuana, pot, dope, ganja, Mary Jane, cannabis. It's got many names and many uses. Whatever you want to call it, marijuana use is more popular than ever. More and more places are legalizing marijuana for recreational purposes as well as for medical use. But one has to wonder, are there any downsides to smoking marijuana? How bad is it for you, really? Today, Life's Biggest Questions asks, what happens to your body when you smoke weed? Hello and welcome back to LBQ. I'm your host, Charlotte Dobre, and don't forget to like and subscribe and let us know in those comments what topics you would like to see on this channel. Marijuana is the part of the cannabis plant that includes the flowers, seeds, leaves, and stems. Most people consume marijuana by smoking it. When you inhale the smoke, the drug goes into your bloodstream and makes its way to your brain and the rest of your body. If you're eating marijuana, the effect is a little bit different and it takes a lot longer to take hold. But we're not talking about eating marijuana, we're talking about smoking marijuana. Firstly, let's start with what it does to your brain. The main appeal of marijuana is it causes your brain to release dopamine. This is what makes you feel high. In addition to the euphoria, dopamine heightens your sensory perception. This is why food might taste different or better when you've smoked weed. Pain can feel more intense and you're far more sensitive to being touched. Marijuana, like alcohol, impairs your judgment. The way you process information may be different, depending on the person. It is an effective way to combat depression, but once you are going through withdrawal from marijuana, the depression may return with a vengeance. It can also help with anxiety by helping you relax, or it could even make your anxiety worse. Marijuana also causes memory problems. You may find that when you smoke marijuana, your short-term memory is not as sharp. Your eyes can also become bloodshot as THC causes the blood vessels in your eyes to expand. Let's move down the body. Many people who smoke marijuana will cough, experience dry mouth, and a sore throat. These effects are temporary, but smoking it in general is pretty bad for your lungs, and excessive smoking can irritate your bronchial passages, increasing your risk of bronchitis. Frequent smokers will also produce a lot of phlegm. Almost immediately after you smoke weed, your heart rate is accelerated. This heightened heart rate can last hours. Your balance, coordination, and posture are also affected when you smoke pot. After smoking, you will almost certainly develop an appetite. This is commonly known as the munchies. This particular side effect of marijuana can be very useful for patients suffering from AIDS, as well as combating nausea that cancer patients experience when they're being treated with chemotherapy. But if you're trying to lose weight, the munchies is a side effect that causes unnecessary overeating. So if you're on a diet, maybe refrain from smoking marijuana. The medical benefits of marijuana are as follows. It can ease the symptoms of glaucoma by lowering pressure within the eyes. It reduces nausea and vomiting. It's an effective form of pain relief and it reduces inflammation. It eases the symptoms of multiple sclerosis, like spasticity and muscle spasms. There is some research to suggest that THC decreases the risk of tumor growth, but this is still being researched. There are health risks associated with smoking marijuana. The risks, while not as severe as smoking cigarettes, are still evident. Marijuana smoke does contain chemicals as well as carcinogens, so there is a high chance that it could cause an increased risk of lung cancer. But, according to the National Institute of Drug Abuse, at this time there is no conclusive evidence that marijuana smoke causes lung cancer. Many of the effects of cannabis on your lungs are temporary, and will go away once you stop smoking. There still needs to be a lot more research into the effect of cannabis on humans. Key risk groups that should avoid marijuana are pregnant women, adolescent consumers as it could have an effect on developing brains, people who are predisposed to schizophrenia or other forms of psychosis, as well as people who are bipolar and people who are depressed. But other than that, happy toking. For now, I'm Charlotte Dobre and you've been watching Life's Biggest Questions. If you want to continue on your quest for answers, why not check out our playlist Biggest What Ifs, clickable on the screen right now. Make sure you turn on notifications by clicking that bell so you never miss one of our videos. See ya!